Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 9.3, Problem 1. This is Section 9.3, Problem Number 1. It says, consider a survey in which 1,000 Fall River residents are asked if they have ever taken a course at Bristol Community College. Find p-hat if 200 say yes. So p-hat equals the number of successes, which in this case would be 200, over the number of trials, which is 1,000, and that can be reduced to 0.2. Again, this I feel reduces pretty easily, but if you're not comfortable doing that, just with your calculator, 200 divided by 1,000 equals, and it'll tell you it's 0.2. So the next one, if 750 out of the 1,000 in that survey say yes, so it would be 750 over 1,000, which again, I can see pretty easily is 0.75, but if you're not sure, use your calculator and do 750 divided by 1,000 equals. And that would be the value of p hat, 0.75. So the next one, part C, how about if 75 people out of 1,000 surveyed say yes to the question? That would be 75 over 1,000. Now be careful with this one. It's different. It looks very similar to the previous one, part B, 750 over 1,000. But the 75 gives you an answer of 0.075. And again, this is where it's not a bad idea to do it on your calculator just to be sure. It only takes a second. 75 divided by 1,000, you'll see, is 0.075. Very different than 0.75. The last one, how about if none of them say yes? Well, the number that say yes would be 0 over 1,000, which is pretty easy, that's 0. And the last one, how about if all 1,000 say yes? So you'd have 1,000, numbers say yes, over, total number of people asked is 1,000. 1,000 over 1,000 would reduce to 1. Now, these other values for p hat would be fine. So what would you use this for to make a confidence interval for the population proportion? The last two would not. This is the value of p hat, 0. But in order to find your confidence interval, you have to verify that n times p is at least equal to 5, and that n times 1 minus p is also at least equal to 5. And if p is 0, n times 1,000 times 0, it's not bigger than 5. So this would fail. You actually could not find a confidence interval for the population proportion where your value of p hat is 0. And the same thing is true when p hat is 1. So n times p, 1,000 times 1, is certainly bigger than 5, but n times 1 minus p would then be 1 times 0, which is not bigger than 5. So the bottom two, 0 and 1, that is the value for p hat, but those values would be inappropriate to try and make a confidence interval out of them, just to be very clear on that. The others, A, B, and C, would be fine, but D and E would not.